What is up, guys? Welcome back to another episode of 777 Riding. So, you guys could probably take a guess of what we're doing today. It's that time of year, guys. The lake is empty and it's time to tear it up down there. I'm super pumped right now. Might be meeting up with some new people today, too. I don't really know yet. Just something I talked about this morning, but yeah. Yeah, I did not drop any RC boating videos this year, and I really apologize. I don't know, it was kind of a weird year, to be honest with you. Like, I took the boats out, but I just didn't make any videos. It was just kind of one of those things, you know, charge the batteries, take them out, the batteries turned out, they're bad, they don't work anymore, so, I don't know, it's just... But yeah, we got the bike, and, yeah, it's... As you can see, it's empty down here today, and yeah, should be nice and muddy down there. It rained last night too, so it'll be extra muddy. So yeah, hope you guys enjoy the video. Let's do this. A couple years ago, we were able to make it over there to the other side.
Yeah.
When it was empty, but we couldn't cross the creek because it was so silty. So we had to, we're able to cross right there. And we just had to like freaking hillside it.
Yeah, and somewhere back there, it's been a long time, but like a few years ago, I found an old car back there.
Yeah, oh yeah, it's like right across.
Yeah.
Thank you. race the next day, and here is the result from the ride. It's pretty caked on. I mean, yesterday was a blast though. Gonna be a good workout for the pressure washer. So, little story on this guy right here. Probably, I'd say, a few months ago now, like back in late spring, I found this in the local landfill. And the hose in the wand was beat up, no gas cap, and I still haven't replaced that yet. It turned over, had oil in it. That's the only reason why I took it. And yes, I just, all I did was clean out the carburetor. And I had like dirt and shit in it. And replaced the fuel line. Put a fuel filter on it to the gas since it had no gas cap. There was some sediment in the fuel tank. I just cleaned that out, threw a fuel filter on it. And yeah, that was about it. I mean, it was in pretty decent shape. And yeah, changed the oil and things started right up. The pump surprisingly works still. That thing works amazing. Found a landfill. One thing about pressure washers too is that living up here, you know, it freezes every winter. We get a lot of snow. And people leave water in the pumps and that water will freeze. It'll expand and it'll crack the pumps. And honestly, I was surprised that that pump wasn't broken. And yeah, I'll start right up for you guys. It was a pretty cold night, so I'll give it a cold start. Probably should bleed the hose first. Yeah, replace the wand and the hose. Let's just do this for a few minutes. All right, let's give her a cold start. But yeah, this thing, we'll start up three poles cold. Could try starting it with one hand. Well, I spent a good few hours here getting all this mud off. Would you like to work my way from the top and go down? Get back to you guys when it's all cleaned up. It's gonna take a long time. Well, it's a good few hours later. She's finally back to nice and clean again. Oh, what a freaking mess. Yeah. Honestly, I'm just not in the mood of doing this right now. And that it took a long time. I mean, I had to pull the seat off. I had to pull the chain guard off. I had to pull everything off pretty much. And about 400,000 hours later, finally got the bike all cleaned up. It's back to looking fresh again. That was a lot of freaking work. I put a good 100,000 miles on the pressure washer. Spent literally the whole day just cleaning this thing. It was freaking crazy. And yeah, I'll only do that ride like once a year just because it's just a lot on the bike, you know. I mean, the freaking chain was rusty. There's mud in the air box, something I've never seen before. I had to pull the chain guard and the skid plate off. It was bad. Yeah, it's just a lot of cleaning too, so I'll only do that ride once a year. So yeah, hope you guys enjoyed. Yeah, it was still a blast though. It was totally worth it. It was a lot of fun. And new tire seems to be holding up good still. I'm so glad I got that thing though before doing that ride, because I don't think I really got stuck once. I mean, I was getting through the mud pretty good. But yeah, it's probably the muddiest my bike has ever been. Yes, I'm gonna leave the skid plate off because probably wouldn't be a bad idea to change the oil. I was running pretty hard yesterday and I haven't changed it for a while now, so it's been more than 10 hours, but it is what it is. I cleaned the air filter too. I mean, like I said, there's mud in the air box, so might as well clean the air filter. Not gonna lie, I was looking pretty bad too. I haven't cleaned that in a while also. Yeah, it's at the point. I'm ready for these guys right here. I've done enough dirt biking this year. I'm ready to hop back on this. Actually started recently, three poles. Didn't drain the gas out of it. Doesn't have a fuel valve because it's fuel injected. So I just left the gas in there. It's non-ethanol, so it's old, but it's not going to destroy the fuel system because it's non-ethanol. But yeah, I'm ready for snowmobiling. Yeah, with that said, guys, hope you enjoy that video, and yeah, hope you guys have a great rest of your weekend. Peace out. See you next time. Adios.